Hey guys, I am Uncle Bernard and welcome back to Firewatch, where I don't know where we left off. Okay, we're back in. Well, I remember where I left off. I was stuck. That's the way I came down. So yeah, I couldn't figure out how to get out of here. I'm guessing there's something. Maybe there's a way up that I've missed, because that's clearly blocked off. There's clearly no way you can get to it. Because obviously the obvious way to do is to follow the lake, because that's a straight shot. Ooh. My game just lagged then for a second. So what's this way? What's this way? Because there may be a way here that I missed. This is a new way, I didn't see this way. God, I thought something was going to happen then. The way he just suddenly slowed himself down. Nope, guess I have to go around.
Whoa, Delilah, the trail I hiked in on, it's...
Oh, I found a turtle.
It's gone.
What is this, the Twilight Zone?
No, there was a rock slide. Is there another path out of the thoroughfare?
Let me think.
God, I guess I'm lucky I wasn't on it when it happened.
Yeah, for sure. You know, without some impossible mountaineering, there's not really another way out.
So what the hell?
We'll fly you out? I mean, sometimes folks get cut off by fire and we just scoop them up when it's time to go.
Okay.
Don't be nervous.
I'm not.
Well, you sound nervous.
Well, the fact that I could always just hike out was some comfort.
I promise I'll be here for you in this difficult time.
Huh. I found a turtle.
Whoa, I found a turtle. Maybe it's a tortoise. It's a thing with a shell.
Well, isn't that something?
It's actually pretty cute.
Well, Henry, if you decide you want it to keep you company, nobody will mind.
And what do I call it? Looks like a...
Turt Reynolds. Shelley Duvall, the Bucket Jr. Turt Reynolds. I like Turt Reynolds.
Well, now I can't wait to see him.
The mustache is impressive.
You tell him I love Cannonball Run.
The chair is blocked. Well, I guess I'm not going that way. I'm keeping you. I'm going to keep him. Mr. Turt Reynolds and Bernard. Love turts. Aw. Me and Turts. For BFF, so I'm gonna get BFF rings and everything. Okay, let's try up here then. I'm guessing I'm not heading in the direction of my cabin again. Oh no, I am heading back. Well, well, how do I go then? I guess I could head towards Cripple Gulch again. Yeah, let's head towards Cripple Gulch. If I remember correctly. I know I just looked at the map, but I've forgotten already. It should be this way. Get back on the path. Right, let's have a look. Map. Yeah, I'm heading the right way. I need to turn left here. Then carry straight on and I should get to Cripple Gulch. I still haven't got the key to this one. Is this one I opened? Ah, that's the one I opened. It's the medicine wheel, if I remember correctly again. Yeah, so I need to carry straight on. Assuming this is straight. Yeah, either way, this will get me a scuffle gulch either way. I'm just keep going this way. Because that's the only way I can think to go. I can't see any other way in which I can get past it.
What are you going to do when the fire season wraps up?
Are you going
to be with her? Just go back to Boulder? You should go be with her.
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Well, why not?
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents, I think they always thought she could do better, and that I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
Aw.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it.
Aw. Not nice.
I'm down by Cripple Gulch.
You ready to give it another shot?
Do I seriously have to?
To get down to Five Mile Creek? Yeah, afraid so. It's quite a ways downhill from here.
Again, he hasn't, he's not fastened himself on, nor has he, secured the line. Hey, well done, he didn't die. Can I apply? No. Aww. Wait, just say, I'm alive. I didn't fall down Cripple Gulch. Oh yeah, I forgot this is the bit where I can't seem to get around no matter what I do. Give me a rock. What the heck happened to that tree? Been pulled up by the roots. So at least I did one thing I was told to do, which was find the turtle. Which I did unintentionally, but I found the turtle. Oh look, beer cans. Oh no. Clean. 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 So the column of smoke. I can't see it anymore. If I keep moving, I'll probably see, I'll come across it again. There's the column of smoke, right. Yeah, I can swim. Oh, but I can't swim far. So, well, I guess going here ain't a good idea because I haven't got any way of going, of getting to it. There's no obvious way. No, I have to head back, I think. Let's have a look. Because this is the way I thought I could go. So I guess I could rappel. I think there's got to be a rappel line down there. Yeah, judging by the look of it, so yeah, that is a symbol. I even thought of rappelling down there, but I thought I'd just carry on there. And I love just the look of the sunset and all of that. It's just so nice, so relaxing. Again, another cache. I don't have the code. I don't know how you get the code, but I don't know what's in there. Ooh.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Yep, just got the stream now. So once I get out of this lush area, I can see where I am and hopefully look at the column of smoke. We're judging by the sun, I can't see it. Oh, look at music again. guessing I'm in the right area by the fact I've got music.
It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby. There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around. Found one of their empties. Guess we're on the right track.
Roger that.
So, column of smoke. I'm not seeing the column of smoke again, but have a look. I'm near where they're meant to be, but I think just, you can just see it there, there's a campsite to my right. If I head up there, I'll probably come across them. Aha!
I see a campsite and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
No, it seems like it. I swear, they must have drank 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down and don't let them see you.
What a job this is.
Stomp it out, make sure nothing happens. Right, I stomped out.
I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's on the magazine. Name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp.
Dangerous hunks.
Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines.
More beer? Case of beer? Half empty.
A full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication.
And those who don't know what's coming for them. A tent here.
The tent looks like it's been through the shredder, which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back.
You've got that camera.
I really
did. It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking.
What camera?
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
Gonna? Can't now. Tent, sleeping bag, note.
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Dear Psycho, I hope you're fucking happy. We're leaving and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped on us in the lake and then came and destroyed our campsite and all of our stuff. Oh, and stealing panties is gross out. I didn't steal any panties, did I? You're probably a mental fucking axe murderer and are so going to jail. I hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks, dick. Hot.
They're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
I'm gonna call the police. I'm gonna
call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No.
I didn't do anything to them. It looks like someone had it out for them.
Then why do they think it's you?
Fuck, I don't know.
Huh.
Hey, I don't.
I believe you. Come on, Henry.
Did I steal their panties? I couldn't have. I'm sure I put them down.
Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know. But they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back. And we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Day 3. So apparently this game is around 4 hours long. I don't know how many hours I've done. I think maybe an hour, maybe two. But I'm probably not going to finish it in this episode because I don't know if I can get through a full day. I will obviously try, but I don't know how much battery time I have on this, or how long recording time I have on this camera. Hopefully I've got enough just to finish this episode out. Because I'm enjoying it, I really am, it's intriguing. Fanboy's downstairs to patch the window.
Hey, Henry?
Hello.
What do you look like?
What?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Like Burt Reynolds, if Tom Cruise had a good-looking twin. Do you know Rolly thing? Like Burt Reynolds.
I get confused for Burt Reynolds all the time.
Oh, is that so?
Women say that we have a similar musk.
Uh-huh.
Hey, you ask.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. Huh. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
I like to look nice, usually.
I don't know. I like to look nice, usually. Well, I try now, I guess.
Had a bit of a schlubby period, did we?
Yeah, a good 25, 30 years, yeah.
But, now you'll put on a clean shirt?
Yeah, well, I have one that I got for Christmas, actually. Just, it's navy with white buttons, but I like it. I don't wear it that much, though.
Well, it sounds just perfect. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
Just tell me about your face. I'm enjoying my thin mustache and long scar. My nose has been broken.
A pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right.
Ah, there's a bug.
Perfect.
What?
I wanna
perfect.
Know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
You're
I'm
what?
Blue.
Is that okay?
That's fine. I don't mind.
Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Yeah, I'm supposed to that. Happy.
They're happy, I think. I mean, I've been told they look happy.
Julia told you that, huh?
Look, I don't know how to describe eyes.
Happy is good. That's good. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Oh, the Jason stuff. Okay, you done perving on me now? Drawing my thickly mustached face and happy eyes. So where's this last board? There's the last board. A cinder block. Drop it. Yes, because that's totally a real thing for me. I don't have a thick beard, but I have happy eyes, or at least I try to. Okay, let's finish boarding up this window and see what life's gonna have in store for me.
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh. Yeah.
Okay.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task, and I'll give it to you.
I'm ready.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Of course.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not
awesome.
That comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually
had
a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Day 9? Oh, I guess I'll sit in my nice comfy, but I don't have a chair near me. Well, I do, but there's one that's just about arm's length away, but I'm sat in a bed, which is comfy enough. So what are you going to store for me now? What am I doing? I mean, a sandwich.
No. Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
Ah, it's just great. I might never leave.
Never leave.
Well, I called with some bad news.
Of course
you did. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got
great
parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
Yay! Aren't I just the lucky duck? Happy to be questioned.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not going to be an issue. If they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
It's worth mentioning.
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
Enjoy the sunset.
Thank you.
Day 15!
I'm that close to the end. Is this when things start going shit? Don't surprise me. I wouldn't be surprised if I've done something absolutely terrible to get this ending. But hey, you never know, could have done something really good. Probably not though.
Henry.
So far.
Henry, wake up.
What? What's going on? What?
Oh, I'm awake.
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
What? Why?
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Toss to Julia. You're the big dumb idiot.
Dumb idiot.
Oh, baby, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
I'm fine, how are you?
Are you? Everything good there? Jules?
What? Oh, sorry, Henry. Yeah, I'm good.
That's good.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Oh. When's he gonna go to shit? Oh god, I sound like the most cynical person in the world, but it's true. When is he gonna go to shit? It's gotta go to shit at some point. I bet this police thing is gonna catch up with me. I bet you.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway,
yes.
When you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes.
Jerky, nice. Hang on, sorry. Sorry, okay.
You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Oh, isn't that nice? So where am I going? Gotta rappel up.
So, like, 2 weeks ago you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I am.
Good. I'm glad. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. He's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Wallace was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine. He'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that. It'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied, and told my sister he fucked our neighbor.
This is where the fucking supply is.
I've just lied about it for over 10 years. And, for some reason, I wanted you to know. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Hey, motherfucker uppers. Found the supplies. What to do now?
Oh, good. Enjoy.
Oh, what's the fucking code? What's the fucking code? What's the code? What's the code? What's the code? What the fuck's the code? Did you tell me the code and I wasn't listening? That's the fucking camera! Oh, for God's sake. I've only now just found out about it. What's the code? You didn't tell me the code. I can't get in if there's no code. So apparently they're all just 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Ah, 2 forks.
Got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Please tell me the 69 days. I'd love that.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
What about Delilah?
No idea.
What about Delilah? Why the fuck not?
Nice name.
No, you big dummy.
Why not?
I was kidding.
I wasn't.
We're not. You're sweet, yeah. But we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, well then.
What do you think?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire. Even though it's July.
It's March for me. The June Fire.
So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
Wow. What the hell's going on with the fire? I'm sure.
Sure I would. Sounds pretty great.
It is. Are you looking at the fire?
No, I'm not.
Yes, I am.
You should. Let me know when you are.
Okay, I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Me too.
Good. I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. I know it's probably been a while since you've connected with someone the way we have. I don't mean to get all heavy, but it's been really nice. I wish I was over there.
I wish you were too.
We could sit outside. We could talk. We've got these radios. We could,
What could we do?
What could we do?
Well, let me tell you. You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
No, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find?
Okay.
There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Sure.
Sure, no problem. Remember me fondly.
You are such a drama queen.
Yeah, well, I've seen what they can do to a tree, and trees aren't even food.
For me, I am
food.
Henry. What can it say?
Yeah,
welcome. Yeah. Alright, I'm here. Oh, no. What the fuck?
Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the Fish and Game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
What the... it's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone
Holy
has
shit.
Written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Yes, way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried.
Okay, strange noise towards the canyon.
You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, devastating.
Well, I'm keeping all this. I'm gonna fucking let them keep it. Fuck no.
Just let me know, okay, buckaroo? Oh, God. I don't know why I just called you that.
Where's the canyon? Where's the canyon? How's the canyon? Where the hell's the canyon?
I found a walkie-talkie out here too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
Well, get it if you haven't already, and then we'll figure out whose it is.
Will do.
Ow. The fuck?
Henry, are you there?
Ow, my face.
What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold-cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now.
Oh, God, that's true.
It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
I know what I saw.
I know what I saw. Hey, it was our words with initials for our names, H and D, clear as day.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Off my head, yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry. I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
You know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with a walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who.
I'll guess the bottom. I'll get the bottom of this.
Great. Just keep a clear head. Don't, you know, do anything crazy.
Like taking a job in the middle of nowhere with literally no escape from whatever or whoever is out there?
Well, I meant, like, kill anybody.
You got it, boss.
Yeah, boss.
I'm hiking through the canyon. Which way is my best bet for getting to Wapiti Meadow?
It looks like you can find a trail on the north shore of Jonesy Lake, towards the west.
Thanks, D.
Welcome, H. Okay, let's have a look. So, I told you it all got tits up. So if I carry on, there should be a rappel spot just a bit further on in the canyon. Not far. Ooh, someone's dropping.
Has anything strange been happening on your end?
No, nothing really.
Nothing really or nothing?
Nothing. My door was open the other night, but that's not strange.
That doesn't sound like nothing.
Yeah.
It's nothing, I promise. Keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground. Kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No. Okay, let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
I told you I finna go to shit, and for God's sake, my blooming phone. I don't wanna put it on that, so it's paused. Carry on recording, okay. Well, there was a rappel spot, but I haven't got it. So I'm going to just carry on. Good about the music, I'd say, that's a good thing. Are the artists 1, 2, 3, 4? 1, 2, 3.
A horn or an antler or whatever.
Well, antlers are made of bone and horns are made of the same stuff as your fingernails.
I guess this is a bone.
Antler. A ranger must have found it this spring.
Back in there. Oh, drop on the floor, out of the way.
Ah!
Ah! Got a flashlight. If I knew the road was 1, 2, 3, 4, I would have just done that. So what if I get updated? So I have to hike all the way up to get to the fence to get to Wapiti Meadow. I swear to God, if I've gone the completely wrong way, I'll be pissed. My sissy would be as well. I wouldn't be happy. Well, I'm guessing I've gone this way for a reason, and they haven't just done it to annoy me. So I'm back at the telephone lines again. Did it even fix those telephone lines from like 5-6 weeks ago? So the next over here, I think I have to go.
Who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance that they had anything to do with those girls disappearing?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
Well, see what you can do to get past it.
Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Okay, yeah, I'm not going to be able to continue this. But judging by the very, very, very sporadic days, I'm guessing I'm pretty close to the end, I'd say. But I'm not going to be able to continue in this episode because everything is dying. My camera is slowly dying. My controller is dying. And I've gone on for about an hour. So I should have this finished by next week or maybe this week if I record a second episode. You never know. So anyway, thank you for watching and I'll see you in another video. Bye, guys.
What does she have?
What? Oh.
She's got Alzheimer's, like dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she?